I had single-sided congestion, I noticed, for pretty much the whole month of November of 2020. I was able to schedule with an ENT who I had never met before and walked in his door, and he immediately scoped me and realized that there was something in a spot where there shouldn't be. So we did a quick in-office CT. I remember him saying to me, "What's that doing there?" and thinking, "You never want to stump your doctor." My name is Angie Reed. I'm from Scottsdale, Arizona, and was diagnosed with an esthesioneuroblastoma. I took it upon myself to start researching to see who the big players were in this specific kind of cancer. And I came up with a few institutions, but the first one that I called and made contact with was Hopkins.
I first met Angie in 2020. She came in from Arizona seeking care here. She wanted to live and she wanted to do everything. And I wanted to help her do that as best I could. And I didn't do this alone. Dr. London and Dr. Galey and their teams took care of the surgery part of things. And because the tumor was aggressive, we needed to follow that with radiation. And we determined that proton radiation would give her the best outcome. Proton radiation therapy is a type of radiation using heavy charged particles that, when used appropriately, can reduce excess dose spillage into other intervening organs of interest. More and more opportunities have been figured out for patients to reduce toxicities, particularly in the central nervous system and the head and neck area. The technology is using a form of radiation, but it's using a different technique than regular X-ray treatment. In doing so, we can spare the side effects of the known toxicity of radiation therapy.
The Proton Center is a pretty special place. I had my first appointment with Dr. Page, and she explained that she works in conjunction with a number of other physicists in order to be able to look at the scans and make sure that the treatment that you receive is customized, not only specific to your tumor, but specific to you. And they're looking at your own anatomy and figuring out exactly the right way for that being to be able to attack only the area that it needs to.
Proton radiation isn't available everywhere. I'm proud to be at Hopkins, where we have one of the newest machines and the best technology there is, with all of the bells and whistles that we have, including onboard imaging, where we can verify the position of the patient before that beam turns on to give even more accuracy to where we're targeting. It's helpful to have access to such great technology right here in the National Capital Region. One of the most incredible parts of being a radiation oncologist is the idea that I do get to follow patients through their lifetime after cancer. I see them discovering new things and reaching their life milestones and their goals and making new goals. And it just gives me a thrill to get those updates and see them thriving after something that was hard. It's inspirational.
I think that the best part of all of this is that my doctors have instilled a confidence in me that my life is going to continue down the path that I've always envisioned. You know, my husband and I are getting to a point that we'll be able to enjoy our retirement together, overlooking the ocean or a lake, holding hands with my husband, watching the sunset. I'm grateful that the care that I've received is going to allow me to have those same dreams that I had when I said I do to the man that I'm with today.